Hello student, welcome to the last session of this chapter, that is factors and multiples. Today I am going to start the test of divisibilities. Test of divisibilities, students, this test of divisibility is also called the divisibility rules. And we have following rules which we are using to check whether the given two numbers are divisible by or not. Suppose two numbers are given to you and you don't have to divide the numbers, you don't do the actual calculation or dividing the number, but you have to tell whether the first number is divisible by the second number or not. For that we are using test of divisibilities or the rules of divisibilities, right? So the first divisibility rule is divisibility by 2. Divisibility by 2, a number, this is a rule student, a number is divisible by 2 if its ones digit, this is very important, if its means that number, if its ones digit is 0, 2, 4, 6 or 8. Or we can say that if a number ends on 0, 2, 4, 6 or 8, that number is divisible by 2. In other language, we can also say that a number is divisible by 2 if it is an even number, because the even numbers are divisible by 2 and all the even numbers are ends on 0, 2, 4, 6, 8. So this is the first divisibility rule. If it is a small number, you can easily divide the numbers. So let's give an example, like your number is 24708. This is a very big number, so without actual dividing you have to tell whether this number is divisible by 2 or not. So yes, you can say yes, this number is divisible by 2. Why? Because the number ends on 8 and 8 is an even number. It means the whole number is also divisible by 8. So this is the rule, student. I hope you understand this first rule. Now student, I'll take one example just to prove that the first rule we have already discussed just now, the first rule is divisibility by 2. So the question is, check whether the given number 26, 353 and 69,470 are divisible by 2 or not. So students, you don't need, please don't divide the numbers in the rough. By using the rule you can give the answer, like 26. This last digit is even number, so you can write it is an even number, so it is divisible by 2. That's it. The second one is 353. Last digit is 3 and this 3 is not an even number, so you can write it is not an even number, so 353 is not divisible by 2. The third one is, the third part is 69,470. Again you have to only check the last digit, because the ones digit should be an even number. Again this is 0 and 0 is an even number, so again you have to write the same statement, it is an even number, so 69,470 is divisible by 2, right? So this is the way to how to do the calculations, how to do the answer, how to check whether the given numbers are divisible by 2 or not. So student, the next divisibility rule is divisibility by 3. A number is divisible by 3, a number, any number is divisible by 3 if the sum of all the digits, sum of all the digits means the number given, we have to check whether the sum of all the digits given in the number is divisible by 3 or not. Let me explain with the help of example. The question is, which of the following is divisible by 3? The three parts are 53, 207 and 1728. So what is the method exactly? Write 53 here because the first part is there. Sum of all the digits. Write sum of the digits. This is also fine. Sum of the digits, there are two digits, 5 plus 3, 8. This 8 you have to check whether, what is the sum? The sum you have to check whether the given sum is divisible by 3 or not. Is 8 comes in the table of 3? No. So you have to write, as 8 is not divisible by 3, therefore 53 is also not divisible by 3. This is the language, student, this language you have to use while doing the question. Let's take the second part. 207. Again write sum of the digits. Here are two digits, three digits are there. You have to show 0 also. 2 plus 0 plus 7 and the sum is 9. Is 9 come in the table of 3? Yes. So you have to write as 9 is divisible by 3. Therefore, 207 is also divisible by 3. Right, this is the third one. Let's do the calculation here. 1 plus 7 plus 2 plus 8. What is the sum, students, here? The sum is 18. The sum is 18. Again, you have to write, yes, 18 is divisible by 3. So, the whole number 1728 is also divisible by 3. So, this is the way how to check the divisibility rule of 3. If any number is given, whether the small, that is a small number or a bigger number, you have to use this method only. The third property, the third rule is divisibility by 5. And the rule is, a number is divisible by 5 if the digit in the ones place is either 5 or 0. Question is, check the number 50 and 72 are divisible by 5 or not. So please, student, again, this is my advice. Don't divide the numbers. Directly you have to write the answer. So what is the main thing? The number ends on either on 0 or on 5. Right. So here this number is end on 5. So what we have to write here? 50 has 0 in the ones place. Therefore 50 is divisible by 5. The second number is 72. 72 is the number, and you can easily see the number and the ends, the number, this number ends on 2. This is neither 5 nor 0. So what you have to write here, 72 have neither 5, neither 5 nor 0 in the ones place. Therefore, 72 is not divisible by 5. Right, student? The third, we have already done. The fourth one is divisibility by 10. A number is divisible by 10 if the digit in the ones place is 0. Only 0. The number should be end only on 0. No other number should be there. If any number is there, you can just check the ones place is 0 or not. If the ones place is 0, yes, definitely the given number is divisible by 10. So which of the following is divisible by 10? The two numbers are given here, 117 and 1120. If we start with 117, we can easily see the number on the ones place is 7. 117 has 7 in the ones place. Therefore, 117 is not divisible by 10. Simple and easy way. Right, the second one is 1120. So you can write 1120 has 0 on the 0 in the ones place. So student, we can easily see this number ends on 0. So 1120 has 0 in the ones place. Therefore, 1120 is divisible by 10. Easy and simple language there, and directly you can do any question, any whether the number is small or big, you can use the divisibility rules and you can easily find whether the given number is divisible by the another given number or not.